Have you seen that new U-turn challenge?
Yeah, the Samantha one.
No. Guys, it started!
How do you do it?
Alright.
Perfect.
Minasan, konnichiwa. Divya this.
Hello everyone, I am Sokku.
We are here back with the second episode of our series, Get to Know Japan. And the episode is
Etiquettes and Punctuality.
Etiquettes are the most important amongst the Japanese. So if you want to know more about the Japanese culture, make sure you know the basic etiquettes of Japan.
Being punctual is always referred to as being on time. And talking about being on time, a country which is more likely to come into everyone's mind is Japan.
In Japan, people generally greet each other by bow. The bow generally ranges from a small nod of the head to a deep bend at the waist. A quick informal bow is at 15 degrees, while bending the torso up to 30 degrees is considered to be much formal. The deepest bow involves bending up to 45 degrees while looking at your shoulder. The more a bow is held, the more respect is shown.
Shaking hands is very uncommon in Japan. Shoes are removed not only in home, but also in traditional ryokan, temple, castles, and other historic buildings. The entrance part of a Japanese house is called genkan, that is where you leave your shoes. And you point your shoes towards the entrance rather than facing into the house.
It is not customary to tip in Japan. Instead, it is polite to say gochiso sama deshita while leaving, which means thanks for the food.
In Japan, people use different set of slippers for washroom. If in case you're in Japan, make sure to use a different set of slipper while using the washroom.
Wait, do not shove your card into your trousers back pocket. In Japan, like in China and Korea, first name follows the family name. For example, a person with the first name Ichiro and the family name Suzuki will be therefore Suzuki Ichiro rather than Ichiro Suzuki. When talking, do not call someone with their names unless they are really familiar to you. Use suffix san, which is for elders, strangers, and to higher officials. Use suffixes chan and kun while talking to people who are younger or familiar to you, where chan is for girls and kun is for boys. Japanese always arrive on time, no matter whether it's a casual meet with friends or an official meet in a company. They're in a habit of being on time, which reflects their culture. Japanese students are late in Japan for less than one day in a week. Teachers or professors may punish them by lowering their grades for being late.
A survey done in Tokyo reveals that only 5% of women and 4% of men in Japan have their wristwatches set inaccurately.
No doubt, Japan is one of the most punctual countries in the world. Moreover, it excels any other countries when it comes to public transport system, especially railways. In Japan, not only a minute, but seconds make difference.
It is said that in Japan, the transport system is so accurate that one can tell the exact time just by seeing the arrival and departures of the trains. The high-speed Shinkansen or the bullet trains are the best examples of the punctuality in the world.
According to Japan Railways, which is one of the main railway companies in Japan, an average delay of a train in a year is 0.9 seconds, which also includes the uncontrollable delay caused by the natural calamities like earthquakes and tsunamis. In 2017, a railway company apologized to the public because one of its trains departed 20 seconds early. Don't you think living in such time-conscious society is very difficult? No, I don't think so. Once you get used to that, it'll be very easygoing and you'll get habituated to it. But people from other societies and other cultures who are not habituated to such kind of situations find it very difficult.
Here's a quick summary of today's episode. In Japan, people greet each other by bowing. A quick informal bow is at 15 degrees. A formal bow is done by bending up to 30 degrees. And a deep bow is 45 degrees. Shaking hand is not common in Japan. Footwear is removed in indoors. Do not tip in Japan. Different set of slippers are used for washroom. Do not shove the business card into the back pockets of trousers. In Japan, first name follows the family name. Don't call Japanese by name. Instead, use suffixes san for elders and chan and kun for boys and girls. Japanese are punctual to casual meetings too. Japanese students are late to class in less than a day in a week. 5% of women and 4% of men set their wristwatches inaccurately. Japan has one of the best public transport systems in the world. An average delay of a train in Japan is 0.9 seconds.
Gochiso sama deshita.
So that's it for the second episode of the series, Get to Know Japan. We'll be back soon with the third episode. Until then, stay tuned.